My name is Daphne King. For those of you who don't know me, I'm the director of the Art Gallery. This evening, I'm really excited to have Dr. Susan Benningson and Lingguan Cheng here for our talk, Ink in Our Modern Times. I'll just briefly introduce Susan as well as the artist, and then I'll let them get on with their talk and discussion. So Dr. Susan Benningson is an independent curator and professor of Asian art history at the New York University. Her recent exhibitions included Summoning Memories, Art Beyond Chinese Tradition at the Asia Society in Texas. It was on contemporary ink painting by artists of Chinese descent. She also did another exhibition for the Asia Society Triennial in New York in 2021 called We the People, Xu Bing and Sun Shen, Response to the Declaration of Independence. And from 2013 through to 2019, she was a curator of Asian art at the Brooklyn Museum, and she helped them reinstall the permanent collection at the permanent collection of Arts of China galleries, and she also co-curated the Arts of Korea galleries. And she was responsible for the acquisition of more than 50 contemporary works of art for the Brooklyn Museum's permanent Asian art collection. She was formerly worked at the Princeton University Art Museum. She received her PhD in Chinese art and archaeology from Columbia University, focusing on Buddhist cave temples at Dunhuang and the ancient Silk Roads. Her forthcoming exhibition that she's working very hard on is a retrospective for Xu Bing at Asia Society in Texas. It's called Xu Bing Word Alchemy, and it opens in February of 2024. And then I'd like to introduce Lingguan Cheng, our artist who made these beautiful paintings here. Lingguan Cheng is known for his work that integrates Western classical sketches with Chinese ink paintings. He studied in Sichuan Academy of Fine Arts and graduated in 2002. And since 2004, he has been participating in various art activities and has held solo exhibitions around the world, including in London, New York, Beijing, Shanghai, and Hong Kong. His most recent included a major show at the Guangdong Museum of Art in 2020. In 2017, he was invited to create an ink painting for MGM in Macau. And earlier this year, his work was also on display at the exhibition that Susan curated at the Asia Society in Texas. His works are found in the collection of the Art Institute of Chicago in the US and in Hong Kong at the MK Lau Collection, the Ying Qing Zai Collection, the HSBC Art Collection, and also MGM in Macau. And this is the first solo exhibition that we're holding for Lingguan Cheng. And we'll also be showing his works in the upcoming art fair, Ink Asia, which opens next Wednesday. And we'll also be bringing some of his paintings to London and showing them there in October, at the end of October, for Asian art in London. So without further ado, I'd like to welcome them and let them start the conversation. Thank you for coming.
Thank you everybody for coming. Thank you to Daphne for inviting me to come here. And she's also arranged for me to give a lecture at Ink Asia for the Ink Society next Friday from 5 to 6. So if you can't get enough ink painting tonight, come back next week to the fair. It's a real pleasure for me to be here and to be in this conversation with Lingguan Cheng. I first met him almost 10 years ago when I was a curator for the Brooklyn Museum, and I was visiting artists in China trying to do things to really expand the collection at Brooklyn. And I went to his studio and saw some of these fabulous works. So after I left Brooklyn, I became an independent curator, and as you heard, I'm also teaching at NYU in New York. And so when I curated this show last spring at the Asia Society Texas Center in Houston, I immediately wanted to include his work in the show. One of the things that's amazing about him is you really have to look closely at his work. Because when you look at it from afar, I'm sort of echoing back and forth, when you look at it from afar, you think it's going to be ink painting. When you look really closely, you realize he's using a pen. He's doing it in the way really inspired by Renaissance etchings and old master drawings. And then he's using Chinese ink in addition to that. They're so meticulous. They're so beautifully done. I mean, all I could think of is your eyesight must be really good because of this close work. I mean, and the patience you must have is amazing, particularly given the size of the books. One of the things I think you'll see tonight also is how inspired he is by earlier Chinese art historical traditions. In this room, they're mostly landscapes, but done in a very different way. And in the other room, you can also see him referring to other inspirations from Chinese archaeology. So you might have a Sung painting reference, and then in the other room, you'll see a reference to Sun Ching Dui, which is really topical because the Hong Kong Palace Museum today is opening up a special exhibition on Sun Ching Dui, which we didn't know when he was doing the work, and Daphne didn't know when she was choosing the works for this exhibition, so it's all kind of meant to be, right? So let's just get into the work and start looking at it. Most of the paintings we'll look at are in the show, but I've also included some installation views from the show in Houston. This is an installation view of the exhibition I curated, Summoning Memories, Art Beyond Chinese Traditions. In this exhibition, I had artists from different generations, some of them still living in China, some of them Chinese American, some of them from Taiwan, also artists from Hong Kong. And you can see on the left is Lin Guocheng's work. And on the right is a hanging scroll by Feng Mingchip, who actually happens to be here tonight. So there he is there. And I did not know that when I picked the slide either. And I thought it was really interesting the way in both of them, I mean, Ming is doing abstract calligraphy. And you can get that energy with the vortex of the swirls. And then Guocheng's work also has that kind of, energy, but created from very different brushwork. Okay, so now you can see the work better, right? So this is from 2016. It's called Prehistoric. And it's small, but it's incredibly powerful. And his inspiration was the Qianzi work, which is a textbook which teaches young students how to learn Chinese. And this particular painting is about the origins, from the chapters on the origins of the cosmos. And I think you can see that when you look at this painting. And this is in the exhibition right over there. So you can see how his early works have it's on the far left wall at the end there. So, because I don't want you to go look at all these after we're done with the talk here. And you can see, one of the things that's interesting is you can see some works in black and white, some works in color, and we'll talk more about that, why he transitions to using color. But, I mean, this is an incredibly powerful work. And so, now you're being put on the spot. But can you tell us some of the inspirations for this?
我们可以回到刚才那个另一个前面那个，因为我特别想讲这张画，还有他隔壁的这张，我觉得很巧，两张画摆在一起，这张画画的一个内容是，我觉得我们中国有一个概念叫天，就是天是一个。 很模糊的一个概念，比如说我们中国的皇帝叫天子，然后我们还有一种好像象征着有一种裁判的力量，叫做上天或者上苍。然后呢，其实这张画是比较小的一张画，我画的是一个我想象当中的天空会宇宙当中的事情一直在循环或者在混沌的状态下。 然后呢，旁边这张画呢，其实最初的时候是想画一个细胞，一个细胞当中呢也包含了一个细胞或者一个生命如何演化出来的，然后它又有一种比如说我们的有一个太极的概念，或者说我特地把太极当中有一个鱼的造型，但我把它隐含在里面。 在这两张画当中呢，一个包含了，那事实上呢，画细胞那个画呢又比那个大很多了。然后呢，一个是代表了一个 最小的最小的一个组成元素，然后这个呢是代表了往上看的天空的一种或者宇宙的一种循环。
I just want to mention something about the fish, because when I first looked at the fish the other day when I saw the painting, I couldn't find the fish, and then he showed me the fish. And then I went to his WeChat, and on his WeChat, he actually has a really famous Neolithic plate that's in the World War, in the National Museum in Bindon, and it has these fish nets and this fish, and he posted the Neolithic pot next to this painting, and I'm like, oh my god, that's where he got the fish. It's like, it's excellent. It's like a complete, he's relying, you look at this, and it could be Western abstract painting, right? Or you can have a Neolithic fish from a pot in the National Museum there, and you can have a splash of enlightenment in the middle, or you can have different cosmological signs. I think it's really important to bring your own ideas to it when you look at a painting. He has his own ideas, but you may have completely different ideas when you're looking at the painting, and I think that's perfectly valid, and it means this kind of requires you to interact with the painting, right? You can't just look at it, you have to really think about it. He wants you to think about all those references, and then bring your own into it, too.
我大概能听懂一点，因为我刚才听到了一段，你书婶说看了我的微信，这个让我很意外。是的，就是说，因为鱼这个造型是让在中国的历史上，可以从最古老的仰韶文化，甚至在更早之前，它已经存在了，就是当时我也猜想是不是。 我们史前大洪水时代的时候，这个因为遍地都是水，然后鱼代表了这个水里面不可知的一种东西，它事实上是带有一种生命之源的一个理解。这个也会后面为什么会太极里面会，太极事实上一个造型是阴阳鱼的造型，这个是一个后面广泛存在的一个图腾符号。 然后呢，再回到刚才的那个 Windows 那张画，这张画的一个感受就是说，事实上这张画其实很难用语言特别来解释，就是说，我特别想表达一个一棵树或者一个植物或者一个人在一个城市的一种感受啊，我觉得很典型的就是说，像香港的那个。 中环往上就是傍山，它有很多的房子，层层叠叠的，然后也有很古老的树在当中。我觉得这是一个重叠的世界，而且他们看着相处的不错。But
do you think this is an optimistic landscape, an optimistic view?
我觉得，因为对绘画来讲，它很难用一种乐观，或者我更愿意就是说，是不是大家会在这里。
找到自己的角色，很像那棵树。So it can be foreboding, but at the same time you have the strength of the tree. I like that. Okay, let's go to the next one. This painting is really amazing. It's the one down there, and he was influenced by the very famous Northern Song painting, The Riverbank, which is in the collection of the Metropolitan Museum of Art. Which, if you've seen the painting, well, thank you, Daphne, for putting the picture of the painting next to the painting, so you know what we're talking about. But, it's a Hemingsway, it's a vertical format, and Guo Cheng has turned it into a horizontal format. He's completely reinvented his response to the painting. So, why don't you talk a little bit about why you changed the format of the painting?
刚才我们在谈前面那两张画的时候，其实提到了一个概念是天，因为我觉得在中国这个传统里面，特别是宋代之前的山水绘画，里面一直是有一个概念，我们会想象说山上是住着神仙的，甚至有些山可以通到非常高的地方。事实上，山是一个载体。 就为什么很多中国的那个传统山水，它事实上是这样子竖构图下来的，它带有一种向上的味道，它其实有一种味道很像欧洲的教堂，就是 就当我们往上看的时候，它代表了一种，就是一种可能的一种跟上天的连接。但是我们那个上代或者之前的这种把山水的作为宗教的关联起来的这种味道的时候，因为我那边画的那个原型是来自于大都会的一张很有名的一张画，叫《西洋图》。那么当我们回到现在此时此刻，我们的感觉就是说，其实我们现在头顶上是有卫星的，我们可以时时刻刻的把一个山看得非常清楚，可以建模。我们知道山上是不可能住着神仙的，就是说山水在我们此时此刻它对我们意味着什么。那我觉得这个是我们这个时候的应该提出的一个问题，我们或者说我们这个时间的一个理解方式。所以我特地的把这张画呢变成一个横向的构图，因为我改掉了原来竖着的构图，因为我竖着的构图它事实上有一种形而上的味道，而当它变成一个横向构图的时候，我觉得更符合我们现在对一个山水或者对一个景观的理解。它变成一个横的构图的时候，有点就是感觉我们是可以走进这个山水里面的，它变成了我们的日常景观的一部分。那我觉得就是说，可能山水这个概念此时此刻让我们心中的意义，它是这样子的，因为我们已经不需要通过它的形而上的味道来建立在我们的心里面它神性的部分。
Which is exactly what some painting is all about, that you should enter the landscape and take a journey through the landscape and go from, you know, the foreground to the middle ground to the background as part of your own spiritual journey. One other thing that really strikes me about, I was going to say his brushwork, but his ink and pen work, which is actually mimicking, in a sense, brushwork. You can tell the professor and me right at the point. This section here,it looks like it's coming straight out of some painting. For example, like, I was thinking of a hand scroll by the artist Guo Xi, where there are different kinds of perspective in it, and look at how it creates that sense of depth and distance so that it helps you on your journey as you go deep into the painting. There are lots of things he's using to take you on your journey. You find your point of entrance, and then you journey through the landscape.There's one other thing about this painting I wanted to ask you, which is the box. What does the box mean?
我先讲一讲我现在，比如说，我想告诉别人我在哪里的时候，事实上我会通过手机分享一下我的位置，就王城的一个坐标的定位。那在古代的王城这个坐标定位事实上是非常非常艰难的，那我觉得这种体验是我们和古代是不同的。那在这里的时候，其实一直以来会有一个包括像这种纵深的结构，或者说里面有一个像白盒子这么一个，它其实在我画里面呢，它也有点像是一个坐标的定位，或者也有点像是我们的一个，因为我觉得当我们拥有了一个工具可以准确定位我们在身在何处的时候，其实是代表了人类理性思维的在往前的推进，就是我们懂得怎么用数字去描述自己的位置。那我觉得这一点是非常不同于过往的，我也认为这一点可能是支撑了我们为什么所谓的会有现代水墨的概念和古代的不同的一点，就是说我们拥有了一种用画去描述我们所处位置的一种能力，那么在这里可能是代表一种理性往前的。
So this room is on landscapes. This and this other room is about civilization, different historical references. And as you can see, this is referring to Sanjing and archaeological finds from the Shang Dynasty in Sichuan Province. What inspired you to do this painting?Why are you using color and not black and white?
我们刚才谈到了一个事情，就是说，当我们那个觉得可以量化去这个世界的时候，事实上， 伴随的有一点就是说我们对神性的东西失去了敬畏，因为我觉得当你做商的时候，当你看得很清楚的时候，那么你事实上很难对它产生一种非常彻底的敬畏。嗯，就是当我们那个用显微镜可以看到非常微小的东西，或者说用天文望远镜可以看到非常远的地方的时候，事实上我们的探索空间在扩大，但事实上的我们内心的神性是在缩减的。那这个时候呢，我在想，比如说有什么理由去支持我在往下创作？因为很多东西它都可以被看见，或者可以被非常清晰的了解。那么什么东西引导我去做有意义的事情？这时候呢，我会想到一些因为这次呢刚好不光有一个三星堆的展览，但是它是碰巧发生在一起的，不是一个计划中的事情。那么三星堆呢刚好是代表一种历史上的未可知的部分，那么我觉得这对我来讲它是一个有意思的事情，我通过去再创作，我能获得这种和它建立关联的一个感受。
I think with Sanchin Gui, that's a really good example, because even archaeologists haven't really figured out what these amazing figures mean. And we should all go to the Palace Museum, Hong Kong Palace Museum, and see the show that it just opened up today, right? Can we see the next one?
Sure.
You can see we're in a Han galaxy now. I think it's also really interesting. You see the date on these? These are 2022 and 2023.So these are his more recent works, and in some ways, not like the term, but they're a lot more optimistic, they're full of color. And you avoided my question about color on the last one, so I'm going to ask it again. Why are you switching to color? Or why are you doing, because you did some color before, but you're doing more color now, and is there a reason why?
画家艺术家之前呢，事实上我是一个写程序的，我事实上是从事那个计算机工作，而且蛮长时间的。那么对我来讲，就是说计算机世界的一种体会，包括一个马赛克的这种那个表达方法，事实上是也是我整个知识里面的很重要的一部分。这时候呢，我在想，如果当我把一些那个古代一些图腾，然后放在一个数字的时代的一种体验里面，那我觉得它可能对我来讲也是一种探索。
It's also a beautiful dragon, don't you think? I really like how he's drawing on so many different centuries of Chinese history and Chinese art and also Chinese cosmology. Just auspicious images and different things that really bring you to a different time frame. And he's all over the place, saying from Neolithic to Song to Han. It's really interesting how rich his knowledge is of different historical time periods and the artifacts. And if you do look at his WeChat, you'll see he's going to the museums all the time, really expanding his knowledge and learning more and more about it.
This one?
Yeah, next one. Which is...We're also still in ancient times. Can you talk a little bit about this one and some of the images, the dragons and the fields, and why you chose certain images?
是这样子的，因为我还想加一个我之前没有问到的问题，就是说，当我们要表达一个数字时代的体验的时候，因为我是学计算机或者从事计算机出来的，我为什么还会用手绘的方式来把它们结合在一起？当我的一个感觉就是说，当我想建立一种和古代或者和未来的一种体验的时候，当我还用计算机来做创作的时候，我觉得我会缺失那种人工参与或者说人手工参与的那种。我的感受，我没有办法建立一种特别直接的关联。我在接下去回答这张画的一个内容。我会发现，比如说我们现在的有一个尴尬的一点，就是说其实我们看不大懂 古代的图腾的味道，很多人，包括甚至我如果没有深入了解的时候，事实上我也看不到懂。因为比如说以龙的图腾为例子，这里面有两个龙的造型，里面有一个，外面有一个，它事实上是不同时代的龙的造型。当我们讲龙的造型的时候，事实上呢，我们看这边的那个龙是比较瘦的，它是中国汉代龙的造型。那事实上，那时候龙也是一个图腾，但它地位其实并不算高。这边的这个图案里面，事实上它包含了一个我们要解答一个问题，比如说古代的人在想，我们死后我们去哪里，我灵魂归何处，或者是如何升到天上去。那这时候呢，前面会有一个龙的引路，然后呢，龙的中间的部分还有一个长着翅膀的人，在前面带路，那个羽毛的羽人，然后最顶上那一个才是一个亡灵，死亡的人的灵魂。那由这个构成了，比如说解答了一点，就是说我们死后，如何要去哪里，如何去。然后在这里面的那个龙是唐代的造型，它事实上呢是一个比较在地上走的一个造型，就是唐代的龙和汉代的龙是完全不同的，而且职能也不同，包括跟我们现在习惯上的，比如说我们从明朝。和清朝的龙的一个地位，那它地位已经升到非常高了，可能有到国家象征的味道。最高位的图腾，事实上它是会随着时间的变化一直在产生变化的。然后呢，我想把这种不同时代的一个理解，然后放在一个类似于像数码世界的这么一个味道当中的一个画面当中来，这是。也是我在做的一个探索。
You do a wonderful job explaining your paintings. We have a few minutes left, and I just wanted to give people an opportunity to ask any questions that they have. Does anybody have any questions for Guoqiang? Or any comments on his paintings?
I have a question. Go ahead. Thank you very much for explaining the image of Guoqiang in your picture.And I'm a little bit late, but I wonder, I saw the images, the pictures that you draw, and there's an image of water. I think you are incorporating water into your pictures, your paintings. So that's my feeling, but I'd like to hear your interpretation of water in your paintings.
我们可以回到一个最初的一个，比如说画天空的那张画上面。实际上，我觉得包括水，包括流动的东西，事实上是中国文化里面非常根的部分。它一直会强调这个世界一直在变的，是一直在转化的。那我想就是，水它有时候会代表这种。我还有一种理解方法，就是我们的山和水，事实上也是代表两种属性。山是固定的，水是流动的。就是变和不变的东西同时在发生。那么我觉得流动也是我想在画面里面的一种感受。
Are there any other questions?
Does that go back to your explanation earlier of how you add in the modern position? Or is there a reason for the box? This one is all. 是这样子的，因为我觉得我们现在就生活在一个这样子的一个白盒子空间里面，我们所有的对自然和对山水的一个感受都是在一个白盒子里空间里面发生的。那么它事实上有时候像个盒子，有时候像个窗口。然后我还想补充一点，就是说在我的创作里面还有一个概念，就是说我们那个盒子的容纳是有限的，但是景观是无限的。那么 这个原子当中的一个关系，事实上，包括我们的阴和阳，有限和无限当中，它还有包括沙和水，软和硬的东西，它同时是对立在发生的。
Well, thank you everybody for coming. Thank you, Guo Chun, for explaining your painting.